For many Indigenous people, January 26th is a day of protest, and thousands have taken to the streets to mark the day of mourning, Invasion Day or Survival Day. Record crowds attended rallies right across the country. We start our coverage in Melbourne, where thousands took over the CBD.
I'm Chris Flanders here in Melbourne, and they certainly know how to put a march on down here. Thousands have turned up and literally they're still flowing in down the street here. I'm standing at the front of Flinders Street Station. They've said that January 26th is not a day to celebrate, that there's no pride in genocide, they want land rights and they want a fair go for our mob. So let's have a listen now to what people had to say about today.
Australia Day to be celebrated. You need to erase the frontier wars, you need to erase the shifting off lands, you need to erase the rape and genocide and all of these horrible things that have actually happened, because it's a cognitive dissonance that allows for this day to be celebrated.
I'm really passionate about, you know, young people stepping up, speaking up and taking on the fight for themselves. Our elders aren't going to be here forever, they're not going to be here to always guide us, and we need to take that passion that they have and instill it within us and, you know, take up the fight.
We've got different mobs from all over the place willing to stand by our side, and you know, it's blown me away. We had people back to Bourke Street while we've got the circle down here. So, and it's a true representation of the movement that we're starting to create and, you know, the change that's coming for our people. So, amazing.
I feel very honoured to be here because I am the result of my own ancestors' resilience. I am the result of my own mother, who is at the forefront constantly of Indigenous activism and engagement.
Today is a mixture of emotions. It's about, I think, rocking the boat, and you know, I think it's something that obviously should be brought to attention, you know, instead of kept Australia's worst secret.
In Sydney, the crowds brought with them signs, placards and flags, all adorned with political messages. They gathered to listen to speeches which talked about the growing resentment towards Australia Day.
Thank you for all the consciousness that stands around me that realises genocide is not a celebration.
After the speeches, the rally had mobilised.
Well, as you can see down here at Redfern in the block, there truly are thousands of people that have turned out today to mark January 26. And like I said, there's been thousands of people here right now. They've been listening to some speeches behind me here, and they're making their way down to the Yarban Festival. First, migrating through the city. I caught up with one of the organisers of today's event, Ken Canning. Here's what he had to say.
This is not Australia Day. This is not a day that should be even remotely called Australia Day. This marks the day our people were invaded, the beginning of the murders, the beginning of the slaughters, and telling the public this is not a day to celebrate. This is not a happy day. This is a day that should go down in history as one of the bloodiest things that had happened in the history of the world. And if you look at the true history of Australia, it matches anywhere in the world for atrocities committed from one race against another.
Police were on standby for any trouble and reacted in force when musician Birrigun Dunn-Velasco tried to set alight an Australian flag. But overall, the march was peaceful, with calls for the nation to come together and acknowledge our black history.
Well, here in the nation's capital, as you can see behind me, hundreds have gathered here on the lawns of the Aboriginal Ten Embassy that was erected more than 45 years ago. And today, it's still the centre of Indigenous rights and movement. We started off with a traditional ceremony, welcome to country, song and dance, and then heard from some of our Indigenous leaders about what this day means and how we'll move forward.
This is the day we make our stand and we will fight back.
This is about spiritual healing, not just for our own people, or for our country and for all the people living in this land.
The gathering then marched up to Parliament House and pushed through a police barricade to make their way through to the doors of Parliament House, where a sit-in ensued for approximately half an hour. During this time, some of our leaders, young and old, read from a proclamation and a declaration about sovereign rights and about the usurpation of genocide. And shortly after, everyone made their way back here to the embassy, where it's a more chilled out and relaxed atmosphere right now. But the plan from now on is to have some lectures, discussions and workshops about how to move this sovereign movement forward.
To have our elders and leaders put forth a declaration of sovereignty on behalf of the whole country was a very powerful thing here in Canberra.
I think it was good to get everyone there speaking about sovereignty, and doing our declaration.
It was a good turnout with the younger generation, but also the older coming out, especially the ones that have travelled, talking about sovereignty and treaty, so yeah, it was good.
Here in Brisbane today, more than 1,000 people have turned out for the city's biggest ever Invasion Day march. The day started with speeches at Parliament House before a 2-kilometre march through the CBD, stopping outside government buildings to make their message heard.
Why are you marching here today?
Oh, you know, I'm marching for my ancestors who fought, you know, their blood, sweat and tears for us to be here today. And it's a very emotional day for our people, and you know, this is the smallest thing that we can do, you know, for our mob. And to live, we are the longest living culture in the world, and we've got to be here standing tall, standing proud of that.
It's important that we send a message to the politicians and the you know, the ignorant people out there that don't want to deny the true history of this country.
To all the people who are out celebrating today, what would be your message for them?
Just remember whose land you're standing on. This is Aboriginal land, always and forever.
Traffic came to a halt as the march continued across Victoria Bridge, wrapping up here at Musgrave Park. Organisers say it's the biggest turnout they've ever seen.
And again, the Brisbane community has shown that they are a thinking community. And on this day, the 26th of January, they've come out in record numbers to show that they don't support so-called Australia Day, and they do support the opportunity for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people to have our say.
This is, it's so good. This is the biggest crowd that we've ever had turn out. This is the most non-Indigenous people that I've ever seen turn out. We always get a lot of mob, a lot of families to come to this event, but this is a huge turnout and we're really happy with it.
A show of solidarity that could indicate a change in attitudes across the country.
We just want an acknowledgement of the day and what it means. And for people that are, you know, see this march going through the street, they see non-Indigenous people marching with us, they're like, actually, this is a day that includes me. Our history, our whole history is part of everybody's history and we should acknowledge it together. And I think it's great. People see it and they're like, oh, this isn't a bunch of angry blacks just running through the city. And, you know, we express a lot of anger, but we also express a lot of hope for this day as well.
More than 1,000 people in Brisbane determined to keep the fire burning.
It was a small but passionate crowd that turned out to the Alice Springs Courthouse lawns for what is believed to be Central Australia's first Invasion Day rally. The rally was opened by traditional owners who thanked the ancestors for giving them the strength to speak today.
It is a really special day for us. Like I said today, we wouldn't be here today if we weren't supporting each other and just have an understanding, like sharing our stories, our journeys that we've been through, you know, and sharing them. And I think this is a time for us to heal now. We need to heal, and we are doing it. We are healing together.
This is one of the best days that I've seen for a long time, mate. Thank you for all being here and sharing it with us.
My name's Jimmy, and I acknowledge and thank the blessings that we're on are in the land.
Hello, my name's Jess, and I'd like to acknowledge Aranda Land and Luritja Country, where I've lived the past 4 years.
Well, we've definitely formed like a small little community of people who all stand in solidarity against the same thing. So I guess that's the first thing, is having that little support network and just change the day. I mean, mainly that's the biggest thing, is to change the day. Like, it's not a day of celebration.
While today's rally may have been small, organisers are confident that from little things, big things grow.
I'm here in the centre of Adelaide where protesters have gathered for a sit-in. They've actually blocked the road here where a cultural parade was taking place just a short time ago. I think they were expecting around 100 people to turn out. Certainly more than that here, maybe 200 or 300. And I spoke to protest organisers earlier today and they told me this is a peaceful protest. They're simply trying to get the message across that today is not a day of celebration for everybody.
We're just trying to, I guess, educate people almost as they pass us in the parade and educate them about what it means to us and the deep sorrow we feel about our ancestors.